I just want y'all to see mindset, the difference, right? That I want to just show you why you need to be in more for 24. Because what I'm helping you do is change your mindset. Because once you change your mindset, your money changes. I'm gonna stop right there real quick. For those of you who just all about money, I'm not. I'm about relationships. Because if you're in the right relationship, you're gonna make money. I'm just being real.
You ready? All right.
What's going on, world? Welcome to another edition of the Secret to Success podcast. I'm your host, CJ, joined as always by Douglas. Yes, this is a varsity edition of the Secret to Success podcast, as I like to call it.
I always feel uncomfortable with it, but I know you're telling the truth, though.
Yeah, no. It's the varsity. Maul, Carl, I love y'all. You know what I'm saying? Y'all my brothers. But sometimes, like I said, you know, the varsity come on the court and, you know, everybody else got to sit down. This is the first pod we've done since the Lions lost. And look, I got a lot of texts, a lot of questions. Listen, like, see, are you still mad at it? Like, listen, man, let me tell y'all something. I'm a grown man. I got kids, a wife, a beautiful life. I got a beautiful business partner, work wife here. My life is fantastic. So when you say, CJ, are you mad about the Lions? Are you still? I'm still pissed. With all that being said, I'm still pissed. I'm not going to lie. It's Super Bowl Sunday weekend.
Yeah, it's the weekend.
We about to go to church in a minute. So
y'all see this a couple days. Yeah, we don't know who won yet, but yeah.
You might be able to tell I'm going to church. I don't know if you can tell.
Yeah, I'm going to too.
but I'm still hot. I ain't going to lie. We was up 17 at the half. Things were looking good.
Yeah, no question.
And
no question.
It didn't work out. Let's just say that.
It's a learning moment, though.
Is it?
It is.
I didn't learn that.
Yeah, I'm going to be honest.
I learned to be pissed.
Yeah, no, it's a learning moment. And I'll be honest with y'all. I had no, and again, for all my Lion fans, you know, quit with the, y'all young, bro. I was with Dexter Bussey and Billy Sims. So stop with the, I can't believe you saying this. I ain't get Alliance a chance to win. I'm a football fan. Like, I'm not into, like, my team.
Yeah.
I'm thinking a couple things. 49ers, this is going to be their third time in the NFC Championship. So, first of all, I'm going with, okay, they've been there three times. So, this is going to be third time is a charm. Like, you know, you got hurt twice. Your feelings got hurt. You about to try to get to the Super Bowl. Number two, you playing at the crib.
Yeah.
All right? Number two, you playing at the crib. Home court advantage. We was at the crib, I probably would have been like, all right, we got a chance. But we playing on the road.
We were up 17.
Okay, no, but I gotta say this. So I wasn't pissed, I wasn't hurt, I wasn't disappointed. I didn't think we had a chance to win. It wasn't until the second half that I was like, whoa.
We started texting Super Bowl tickets.
I was like, yo, we really? This the Lions? Now, you got to understand, this is first time with the NFC.
But you did send me a picture of your flight to Vegas.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
We was ready.
I really was like, they don't got a chance. But during the game, I was like, they are who we thought they were.
Yeah.
I didn't realize that.
Let them off the hook.
Yeah, so, but here's what I want to tell y'all.
Yeah.
If we would have kept the same coach and the same mentality, which was, what did he say about the knees?
Bite the kneecap.
So what happened was they came in with that mentality first half.
Yeah.
This is the lesson for you.
Yeah.
So what happened in the second half, they weren't running the ball like they was running the ball in the first half.
Nope.
So they went to something totally different. I'm talking to you like I want to give you a lesson. Yeah. What happens a lot of times in life is that we do stuff that works. Like, I've been chunky. I've been down. When I get down, I go back to my chunky habits. I'm just being real. I tell people this all the time, bro, I don't have no problems losing weight.
Chunky habits.
Sweets.
I just want to know what, you know what I'm saying?
Sweets, pop, eating late at night. Like, yo, I'm not, look, I promise y'all, anytime I get to a certain weight, I don't got no problems going back to a large. It's when I go back and I get where I want to be
that
I'm like.
Which one do you feel better at?
The chunky.
I argue the chunky pastor.
For sure.
Let me say something. Big Luther for sure sounded better than Little Jose. Come on, bro.
And I'm going to tell you why.
Because you got more in the diaphragm.
Yeah,
you
just, but I'm going to tell you why Chunky is better.
Yeah, yeah. Come on.
Chunky is better because you don't have to have no thought process with Chunky. You ain't thinking about nothing.
Yeah. When no stress.
And bro, you ain't going to the restaurant going, okay, I want protein and vegetables.
Yeah, no.
You know what I'm saying? You're not looking at the menu to figure out. Bro, when you chunk, you eat everything.
Oh,
bro. Like, it's no, you go in the store, it's not no stay away from this aisle or stay away from that aisle.
Yeah.
It is no aisle. You don't wake up going,
ain't no aisle.
Did I lift four times this week?
Is there a vegan option close?
Yeah. Did I do cardio enough this week? You don't think about none of that. And so, for sure, Chunky is less stressful. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I know I got my health enthusiast there, but I do want to say
about
this.
Them. Chunky is better.
Both my grandmothers made it to 92, and they ain't do none all that stuff we got to do today. My grandma wasn't on nobody. Neither one of them was on nobody treadmill.
No.
They weren't lifting nobody weights. Nope. They weren't doing none of that. So, but no, I the lesson I learned was, and again, if you really into football like me, I don't even know why this. I'm like, this don't even make sense. Like, for I know football. This don't even make sense. You're up by 17. If you was running and that worked for you, which running never works for you, by the way. Like, you got to be dope to run the ball and be up by 14.
In the playoffs.
It don't work like that. So you running the ball. Then you come back in the second half and you start throwing the ball. Like, anybody that know football know, if you want to get a three and out, you know what I'm saying? The quickest way to get a three and out and not waste no time on the clock is to throw the rock. At least when you run it, you're wasting time on the clock. So not only did we come out and not do what we normally do, we did the very opposite. And guess what they did? Three and out and score each time. Fumble the ball and score in a matter of seconds. They scored three times in a matter of seconds. Mm. Right? So
evaporate.
Yeah. So I will say this to you. And I've been saying this in my More for 24 coaching. And I mean this with all my heart. I'm not playing no games.
Yeah.
If you find a habit that's working for you.
Yeah.
If you find a habit that's helping you in any part of your life, you got to stick with it to the day you die. Like, you can't. I'm telling you, you cannot switch up this morning. And it happened so quick. This morning, I'm doing the More for 24. I'm in the hotel. I've been doing it at the crib. I got a routine. I go in the garage. I get on the ETA cart. I'm in the garage. So nope, I don't wake up my wife. Nobody hear me. I print out my hookup, put it in front of me. I got one of these lights and I go. I get here today. I ain't at the crib. I'm like, E, what you gonna do? I got it on my little phone. I'm like, E, don't do that. Like, don't do that. You can read it off your phone, but don't do that. Stick with what works. So, bro, I had to call my man downstairs, print it off, brought it up, and had it sitting right there. Why? Because it's a habit. It's like, yo, everybody been talking about how you been killing it on the More for 24, and now you about to switch up the routine. Mm. It's like, for what? The routine worked. Lazy. Like, I don't feel like going downstairs. Yeah. I don't feel like going to the, what you call it? The business center. I don't feel like leaving the room. I don't feel like getting dressed. I don't feel like, it was like, no, it worked. So y'all, you know what happened. Made that phone call. Now I got to keep it 1,000 with y'all. 1,000. I made a phone call and told my man, like, hey, if I come down, I need to come without my wallet because my girl's asleep. He was like, bro, I don't know if I can let you get another key without your wallet. I was like, you ain't hear what I just said. If I leave this room, I cannot go back in that room where she sleep, grab my wallet, wake her up, and then go downstairs. I can't do it, bro. Mm-hmm. So he was like, here's what I'll do. Email it to me, and I'll send it up to you. And I was like, okay, bet, but do me a favor. Don't knock on this door.
Oh, please don't.
Don't knock on this door, and don't call here. You text me and let me know when y'all going to be at the door. So I'm teasing, but I'm not. I end up getting the paper, had Jose set up last night. So I had my Zoom light. I had my paper. Ready. And guess what? Everybody was texting me like, E, that was the best one you did in the whole. Why? Because it's a routine. So with the Lions, what happened? You up, you come back in the second half because you up, you playing different. When you was down, it was like, yo, we don't got nothing to lose. But then when you go up, it's like, we got this 17 points to lose. So now you on protective mode. Now you on prevent offense, prevent defense. And now you switch up, and guess what happened? You lose the two quarters that's most important. That's the third and the fourth. The first and second don't matter. It's the fourth quarter that matters. So I'm just saying, for those of you who in your life, you're doing stuff that works, for real, now you scared because you got money. Now you scared because you're in a relationship. You know what I'm saying? Now you're scared because you have something. And I'm just being real. When you start making money, you married now, you got kids now, things are going great. Yeah, you definitely need to be strategic, but you need to keep that dog though. Don't get to a point where now you got something and you're afraid to lose. Like you just got to, whatever got you to that point, I'm just being real, you got to keep doing that.
Yeah, more in 24 is the mission. And, you know, it was funny because I really did start looking at Super Bowl tickets and, you know what I'm saying, the fam, my dad, shout out to my pops who put me on being a Lions fan. Just every Sunday, just disappointed. Shout out to my mother-in-law. She coined the term post-Lions loss nap. Mm. She was like, you know that nap, that good nap you get after the Lions lose? It was just years of just abuse.
Years of that.
But it's funny because you have years of conditioning, right? So it's crazy because we was talking in the halftime. We did start getting excited. Like, all right, we're going to the Super Bowl, stuff like that. And I was looking at tickets. And I've just been looking at, because I never, like, I'm not a big, I know you've been to the Super Bowl a bunch. I've never been like a, I want to go to the game if my team ain't playing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, like, I'm just not a big, like.
Absolutely.
Oh, like, I got a Super Bowl ticket for tomorrow.
Yeah.
And I ain't going.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I had a ticket, but it's just not my thing. Like, I'm not into, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, watching somebody else's team.
Yeah. I just always said, like, whether I die before having or not, I'm going to go when the Lions go. So the one silver lining is we was going to blow a bag for sure.
Easy.
But I was looking at the tickets, E, and I was like, oh, okay. Like, I was like, maybe we should get a suite.
Yeah.
Suite, like 1.5 mil. I'm like, okay, what about the single tickets? Bro, they $3,500, $4,000 a ticket.
Oh, I ain't even seen none of those. The ones I saw was 12,000.
Oh,
maybe,
yeah.
So maybe I saw the ones in the lower bowl.
Yeah, yeah.
That must have been the upper bowl.
This was like decent seats, I'm saying. 4,000-5,000. And I'm like, you know what's crazy? Super Bowl finna be packed out.
Packed out.
And it's crazy because, and we've
can I just say this?
Yeah, yeah.
Super Bowl about to be packed out. The arena. But then the hotel's gonna be packed out watching it. Uh-oh. So it's some people can't even get in the actual game, but they spent thousands to be in the city where the Super Bowl is.
So let's look at it. You're gonna go to the Super Bowl. Flight gonna be at least 1,000. I'm saying I didn't even look at the flight like that, but it's just regular class too, because they inflate everything because they know everybody trying to
Super
go there.
Bowl.
Your hotel room gonna run you at least a stack more. And then you paying $5,000, $6,000, $7,000. You got a family of four. You want to go to the Super Bowl. You tailgate. You got food. You running a $20,000 at least for a family of four. I'm saying maybe 30.
Yeah.
And I'm like, but at the same time, it's going to be sold out.
Yeah, sold out.
And I'm like, yo, when we doing the more in 24 and we talking about having more and things of that nature, like, I was looking at, hope God willing, next year, like the memories that we were about to make as a squad. You know, me and Eve been going for a long time. Like, man, being able to take my pops and our family and Boog, me and Boog been locked in and all of those
Boog
things.
Boog been wearing a jacket, my Axel Foley jacket.
Yeah.
Now, trust, I bought mine in 89 when the movie came out.
Oh, bro.
Jay got that joke on.
And, you know, I was just looking and I was like, yo, it's so many people out here who in lack, and then you got people who can afford to do that, which is not a necessity. And it's like, yo, what's the difference? Like, everybody human, you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, everybody's human. Like I see people and I'm like, yo, that person got amazing talent, they got amazing gifts, and we both know people who we look at like quiet as kept, they way doper than us, but they don't get to that level. More in 24, you've been really schooling people how to get more out of their life. And the one thing I like about the new season that you're in, E, is you're not apologizing for telling people that finances are important.
Yeah.
It was a time in our relationship where, you know, I used to be kind of looking at you like, E, like, bro, talk about the paper. Like, it's important. And I think you were so spiritual.
The church.
E was so spiritual. He's still spiritual. You know what I'm saying? But it's like,
I was religious.
Yeah, but right. But you didn't want, like, it was like, money would be like, seriously, like almost like we didn't even talk about it.
And it's like making it.
Right. And I think we looked at it like, oh, you know, people like being flexing and trying to be like, look at me. I'm like, spending that kind of bread to go to the Super Bowl wouldn't necessarily be, I'm not trying to play. I'm trying to, like, this is a great moment for our family. You know what I'm saying? Like, the Lions mean something to us, you know? And I think it means something even more because we've been the lovable losers for so long. Like, everybody was rooting for us because it was like, yo, the Lions?
Yeah.
And so when I think about more 24 and I think about what you're talking about, I'm just looking like, yo, the cost of life going up. The cost of life going up, but you're not. So what happens? The gap continues to widen, and it's like, yo, I see people and I'm like, yo, like, why are you not developing yourself? Like, bro, I seriously think about how much further I am as a father, as a husband, as a leader, as a businessman, as an entrepreneur, as a friend, than I was 5 years ago.
Yeah.
And it's because we constantly work on ourselves. You know what I'm saying? Like, we talked about it in the book. You and I might have had friction at one point. It's like, bro, we work past it and now we're better because of it. And it's like, you look at people and it's like, yo, you're stuck. You're not moving. And it's like, when we tell y'all to be a part of something, YOUOWEYOU, the devotional, More in 24, it's like, we're trying to show you that developing yourself is the only way to stay ahead of the curve.
It's the only money.
You can't, that, bruh, you cannot get to the next level by looking at other people grow.
Yeah.
You, like, bruh, look at, I don't really go to the, like, my wife do the grocery deliveries, but, like, when I go to the grocery store, I'm like, oh, okay, the eggs is $8.99.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm telling you, a dozen of eggs, $8.99. We're doing the organic, happy eggs, whatever. I'm like, bro, that's $8.99. I didn't even know.
Yeah, I didn't know.
I went to the grocery store. I was like, oh, okay.
I didn't even know how much eggs cost till you said it.
I'm saying we do the happy, organic.
Yeah, like, I didn't know.
$9.
I thought there was like $1.99,
$2. That's what I'm telling you.
Yeah.
And I'm just using that as a microcosm of everything going up.
Yeah.
So if everything going up and you not.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
That's like, why you stressed.
I'm saying if everything was still, bruh, if eggs were still $1.99,
you'd be
good.
You good.
You smooth. I'm not tripping. Yeah. Gas still.
You good.
164.
You good.
I promise you. I don't even want to know how much the gas is out in Cali.
$6 a gallon.
I'm just saying.
Yeah.
It's, bruh, $6 a gallon. So it's like, dog, life is going up.
Yeah, life is going up.
Life is running past you. Yeah. And you looking and you frustrated, but it's like, how much have you grown?
Yeah.
And I'm just talking about, Ian, we could talk about it in More in 24 and what you're doing with the, you know, the people and stuff like that. But I'm like, yo, you still getting held up on the same problems. You and your spouse still arguing about the same things. You still making the same amount of money taking that 2-3% raise from your job every year and you haven't invested. You ain't joined Make Real Estate Real. You ain't got it deeper than the brand. You ain't did More in 24 and you looking and you going, God, you're supposed to be better every day, every month, every year.
So just imagine with me for a moment. You go to your front door and there's a box right there. You take this box up, you bring it inside and you open it up. Inside there are farm fresh, right? Already pre-portioned ingredients and seasonal recipes that are waiting for you and your family to experience. Guys, I'm talking about chef curated meals that you would find at a restaurant. This is exactly what HelloFresh is doing, and that's why it's America's number one meal kit. Whether your resolution is to save money, eat better, or stress less, HelloFresh is here to help you do all three. Say hello to your most delicious year yet with fresh ingredients and chef-curated recipes at a price that you'll like, and they're delivered right to your door. And here's the magic. Each HelloFresh box is packed with farm-fresh ingredients, and everything arrives pre-portioned right to your doorstep for less hassle and less wasted food. Now, if you're anything like me and recipe boredom is a real thing, fear not. HelloFresh has more options than ever before. Dig into their biggest menu yet with over 45 dinner options to choose from weekly and even more market add-on items that suit any lifestyle. And for those hectic nights when your schedule is packed, HelloFresh has your back with their quick and easy meals, including 15-minute recipes designed to minimize mealtime stress. Cooking has never been this convenient. I think the dopest part for me with HelloFresh is the fact that my family gets to cook it together, guys. Like, literally, my kids are cutting up the onions, scallions. Like, they're all a part of the process. We're talking together. All right, so in addition to, obviously, my family being, you know, able to cook together, my kids being a part of the process, one of the things that I really love about HelloFresh is the ease of just making it fit your schedule. The guys, we travel a lot, right? So if I'm gone the next week, the next 2 weeks, it's as simple as pausing my subscription and simply restarting it when I get back. It's that simple, guys. So listen to me carefully. Go to HelloFresh.com/successfree and use the same code successfree for a free breakfast for life. You heard me correctly. Free breakfast for life. There'll be one breakfast item per box while your subscription is active. So that's free breakfast for life at HelloFresh.com/successfree and use the same promo code successfree. HelloFresh, America's number one meal kit. Is 2024 bringing exciting or unexpected changes to your life? Here's a secret weapon to help you face those challenges with more confidence. A great term life insurance policy. Yes, really. Fabric by Gerber Life makes it simple to protect your family's financial future so you can focus on what's ahead, knowing your family is protected if something else unexpected happens. Fabric by Gerber Life was designed by parents for parents to help you get a high quality, surprisingly affordable term life insurance policy in less than 10 minutes. Fabric has flexible policies that fit your family and your budget, with quality policies like $1 million in coverage for less than a dollar a day. It's all online and on your schedule. No appointments, no scheduling, or piles of paperwork. Just apply when it's convenient for you. You could go from start to covered in less than 10 minutes with no health exam required. There's no risk to apply, and they have a 30-day money-back guarantee, and you can cancel at any time. Fabric has partnered with Gerber Life, trusted by millions of families like yours for over 50 years. With over 1,800 five-star reviews, they're rated as excellent on Trustpilot. And Fabric does more than just life insurance. It's a one-stop shop that also has free digital wills, investment accounts that let you save for your kids' future, and you can manage your family's finances right from your phone, so your family is prepared for anything. Join the thousands of parents who trust Fabric to protect their family. Apply today in just minutes at meetfabric.com/success. Again, that's meetfabric.com/success. meetfabric.com/success. Policies issued by Western Southern Life Assurance Company, not available in certain states. Prices subject to underwriting and health questions.
And I like what you're saying, though, because I just want people to practically see this. If things are going up and you staying the same.
That's what I'm saying. You're getting worse.
I want y'all to see
it. That's the point I'm trying to
make. So everything is going up and you right here and it goes up. But here's the crazy part. The reverse to that is if you going up and it's going up, you don't even notice that it's going up. I'm saying right. Just from a.
Organifi. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro.
I just want to show y'all from.
So I'm saying you at least got to grow with inflation.
So I just want y'all to see, though, if everything is growing, so like you in first grade, in real life, you in first grade, and everything else, second grade, third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade, all the grades keep going up, and you stay in the first grade, you're going to be looking up to the, but if it's going first grade, second grade, third grade, but you getting double promoted, like, you don't even see it the way the person who in the first grade, who stuck in the first grade for 5 years, you getting double promoted. So you're not even looking at the people that's growing. You're looking at them crazy because they growing, but they're not growing to the level you growing. You getting double promoted. So you're looking at my man in the second grade like, oh, he only in the second grade. I'm in the fourth. I done got double promoted twice. I'm in the fourth grade. So I just want you to get what he's saying. You're chasing money when chasing money is not going to necessarily elevate you. What I'm trying to teach you in More for 24 is that when you change and chase your mindset, everything else grows around you. I'm just being real. I want y'all to hear what I'm saying. It is the mindset that you should be trying to fix. It is the mindset that you should be trying to shift. So when he said money, the reason why I wasn't talking to y'all about money at first, because the people that I was with had a mindset that money was evil. You know, that's what they preach. Now, I'm
shout out to Rob Wilson, who taught us that money's not evil.
Yeah.
The love of money is evil. You know what I'm saying?
I'm going to be real, though. I was still going after the bag when they were saying it.
For sure.
But here's the crazy part. I was going after the bag, but I couldn't even get all the bag that God had for me because half of my brain was saying, go get the bag. The other half was saying, what you getting is you feel? I'm just saying it was an oxymoron. You feel me? Like I was duplicitous. You know what I'm saying? One hand, I'm doing this. Other hand, I'm doing it. I'm talking about in my mind.
Yeah.
The struggle was in my mind. So the reason why I said, yep, I got to do more for 24 is because I have to show you. Now, I don't know if it's possible. I did a video. CJ did a video. I'm going to show y'all the room. Right? I'm just going to show you real quick mindset. So I told you more in 24. I didn't know this existed. But because I come regularly to do the manager downstairs, yep, like, hey, you ever think about staying in the presidential suite? And I was like,
this ain't the presidential?
Yeah, this it.
I didn't know though.
I was standing in the normal room. Yeah, I was in a normal room.
Oh, okay.
So he was like, you ever thought about standing, because you come a lot. And I was like, I didn't know. I thought the room I had was dope. He was like, no. We got a presidential suite. You should probably stay there. I was like, okay, how much does it
this
cost?
This beyond the presidential.
He said, how much does it cost? No. Didi said, how much does it cost? And I was like, why? Like, why? Why would you ask? What difference does it make? He asking me, do I want to stay in it? You know what I'm saying? So the dude that run the whole hotel, right, he sees me in the room.
Yeah.
I just want y'all to see mindset, the difference, right? I want to just show you why you need to be in more for 24. Because what I'm helping you do is change your mindset. Because once you change your mindset, your money changes. I'm gonna stop right there real quick. For those of you who just all about money, I'm not. I'm about relationships. Because if you're in the right relationship, you're gonna make money. I'm just being real. I'm gonna say this real slow. I used to debate with him about Michael Jordan and LeBron James in terms of who was the greatest player. I used to be in that debate. Okay, I was. I'm just being real. I saw Mike. That was my era. You know, just like somebody might have saw Dr. J or saw Kareem and was like, you can't tell them Kareem.
Bill Russell.
You can't tell them that. So I saw Mike, right? So here's what I told CJ. Yo, I'm with you on the LeBron thing. I will say this. Michael Jordan, and maybe because it was his time frame, made a better decision. Now what I'm starting to realize is LeBron didn't make the best decision as far as I'm concerned. What do I mean by that? He would have stayed in Miami. He probably would have 6 right now, period. So that's what I mean. So I'm taking away the player part. He could have 6 if he wanted to. Meaning what? If he would have just said, I'm staying in Miami, because we see the law of average. He won 2 out of the 4. You know what I'm saying? So just the law of average, he got 2 being there. He would have stayed so many years, he would have got 4. He could, you see what I'm saying? So he go back to Cleveland, and unfortunately, so what I mean by that is, depending on who you playing with, that's your money.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying, you with Wade, you with Bosh, your life going to look different if you went, well, give me some of the names again. Booby Gibson, give me some names. Who were some of the players for Cleveland at that time?
You have a hard time. Zydrunas Ilgauskas.
Okay. I'm just saying, do the math. I don't even know the roster.
What's my man? Damon Jones.
but we know Bosh. We know Wade. We know Allen. Allen was there, right?
Mike Miller.
I'm just saying, who he was with, he didn't have no problems winning championship. We just didn't know which year they was going to win. But we knew that they was going to be in the championship and they was going to have a chance for it. So I changed my mind. I changed my thinking. You get older, you get smarter. So I'm not really into money. If you with Wade, you got a better chance of, you just got a better chance. So I'm trying to get you to change your mindset. So I'm not.
But you can't just be with them, because I think that's the part. You hear it, E, yes, you're correct.
Oh, you know,
but you got to bring something to the table.
You know, I'm
yourself.
Already saying, I'm coming.
You can't just be.
I'm
with
coming as Bron.
Okay.
Right. Yeah, that's,
okay.
I'm coming as Bron. Right,
cool. I just want to make sure.
No, and
a lot of people just think.
Oh, no, I'm coming
I could
as
be.
Yeah. And I don't mean basketball. I'm not on. I don't play basketball.
No.
But I'm saying, as a speaker, what Bron brings in terms of basketball.
But that's what I'm saying. You got to bring. But I'm saying, that's why you need to do an inventory yourself and ask you yourself what you bring to the table to be around somebody like that.
Absolutely.
You see what I'm saying? Because people are like, I just be in the room,
but
I'm good.
I'm going to tell you what it takes. It's the mindset. All you need is mindset. All right, so let me go back. So my man going, we got the presidential suite. I'm like, bet. Did he ask how much? I was like, what difference does it make how much it costs? You on money right now. I'm not on money. I'm on experience. I want to have the best experience.
Yeah.
He said, this is what he said, capital E. He said, be fruitful.
Yeah.
Multiply.
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
Fruitful is you start off in the king's bedroom. Yeah. When you first start doing whatever you do, that's where we all start. We go to a hotel. We just go in. Yeah. Expedia.com, where you get a room as we can. As
Hotwire back in the day.
Hotwire.
Hotwire.
Hotwire.com.
Oh, that was the first.
Hotwire.com.
Oh, yeah. Bed. Come on.
I'm looking to see if they got a pool.
Oh,
if they got, I'm looking for the amenities.
That little swim icon. Bye. You're like, yeah,
you
I got
me?
It.
You feel me?
They got the pool.
They got the pool with me. They going to have it. And so for me, the mindset, I was like, okay, Didi, no. This is not a money moment. This is a mindset moment.
Yeah.
So we're going to go from here to here. Why? Because I went from GED to 4-year degree to master's degree to PhD. Every part of my life should keep whatever is available, I should be going after it.
Yep.
This is a mindset. Your mindset is not you get somewhere and quit. You get somewhere and chill. You get somewhere and stop. The mindset is whatever is next, I'm trying to get. Okay, C was like, okay, you finished with the PhD. Now we need a New York Times bestseller. Like, he came to me and was like, E, when I'm looking at all these other boys and what they did, you don't have your New York Times bestseller. Everybody else got a New York Times bestseller. So that's what's next. We didn't write a New York Times bestseller because we're trying to be dope.
Right.
We was looking at the industry and what's next in the industry.
Yep.
So you.
And we was already number one.
Right.
No, I'm just saying, don't get, yep. No, I'm saying we was already number one this last year.
Yeah.
2 years ago.
Yep.
We was already number one and I said we needed to do that. Yep. You know what I'm saying?
So I said to Didi, don't do that because we got money. So in your brain, what you thinking is, well, we don't want to spend it on this. I'm saying, well, what do we spend it on? I'm stop right quick. Mindset. If we don't spend it on this, what do we spend it on? Well, we might need to save it. So Jalen can get it. What you think Jalen going to spend it on? What you think Jalen going to spend it on? What you think he going to spend it on? What you think Jada going to spend it on? They going to spend it on something. So we the ones working.
Hmm.
So why do I put all mine to the side for somebody that ain't working like I'm working? So they can spend it. Hmm. So mindset. So I'm like, look, and here's the other thing I'm thinking. I'm thinking you're going to get more of what you're going to get more. So I'm like, Didi, whatever we spend, we're going to get more. So okay, even if you're nervous, we got 5-6 businesses. You can take a little bit out of this one. Like, it ain't even like you got to spend it all. You got to take one account. What? So then we get here and it's like, oh, so then we come today.
Mm.
I'm like, yo, I need to get back to the crib because I got to come back in another 2 weeks. And Didi in here going, oh, we only going to stay for a day. And first the mindset was, why are we even? And now the mindset is, why are we leaving? So are you listening to me? Change the mindset. So Didi ain't on presidential suites no more. Now when we go to a hotel, it's actually the opposite. Now she's like, so you got me this room. Why? Because once the mindset is expanded, it can never return to its original dimensions.
Mm.
That's why you got to make sure you expand your mind. Because once you expand it, your mind don't even want to go back to what it was doing before. I got a PhD. My mind will never let me go back to the time where I could barely read or write. My mind won't let me go back to when phonetically I wasn't strong.
You can't.
I can't. It's not possible. My mind
is not. Trying to figure out how to read right now. I know. I can still read. I'm just saying.
And that's why we're telling you to change your mindset, because the only thing that once you change it, it don't try to go back to what it was before. And it's the only thing that's going to keep giving you a return. Them shoes ain't going to keep giving you a return. The car ain't going to keep giving you a return. That house may not even necessarily, depending on what neighborhood you're in, is not going to give you a return. This, once you expand it, it's the only one thing that when you expand it, it spills over to everything. When you change this, it spill over to how you work. It spill over to how you treat people. It spill over how you grind. It spill over how your perspective. It spills over. And here's the crazy part. It's $1,000 to be with ET every single day. And you got a girl who said to me, listen to me, sweetheart, you might be watching this. Don't take this offensively. I'm not
$1,000 of what?
$1,000 a year to be in the program.
Okay, I just want to make sure you said $1,000. They might be thinking it's $1,000 a day, $1,000 an hour.
Listen to me.
You said $1,000 a year.
The person that,
a year.
Listen to me. The person that I paid to help us get a New York Times bestseller, I pay him over a year, $1,000 a month just to stay in his company. He ain't even coaching me or doing nothing with me.
Right.
I just want you to hear what I'm saying. I paid him, I've been paying him $1,000 since we hit the New York Times bestseller. Why? Because if you can help me hit the New York Times bestseller, I'm not interested in not staying in contact with you. I'm just being real.
You're on retainer.
I just got him on retainer. We don't even meet. We don't even talk. I just got him on retainer just in case. And watch this, y'all, so crazy. We sitting down with them about an equity deal. He just hit me like, hey, it's a company of dudes. We about to do something. We want to get you involved. It's an opportunity for you to probably make 8 figures and you don't even got to do nothing but meet with us once a month. That's from what? The 1,000. And you tripping on 1,000. Listen to what she told me. And this is mindset. I'm not mad at you. Don't think I'm upset with you. I'm not. You just have a poverty mindset. And it's my job as a coach to get you from barely being able to dribble to cross over. In terms of your mindset, you barely dribbling. I'm going to teach you how to cross over. Yeah, that's what I'm going to teach you how to do. And when you learn how to cross over, Kyrie, your money different. You can separate. That's what the crossover is about. It ain't about you looking good in front of people. It's about you being able to separate yourself on your own. See, you got to remember, I'm an older dude. They weren't crossing over. So back in the day, what you had to do was get a pick. Somebody had to assist you in you getting separation from another player. I want you to hear me. So somebody got to do this. If you know how to do this, you're creating your own separation. You feel me? And when you can create your own separation, you can make points. That's different. Okay. So I'm trying to help you separate. So you're going to say to me, I thought the word was free. The word is free when you read it on your own. Mm-hmm. Let's just start there.
Yeah.
I thought the word of God is free. It is. When you read it by yourself.
Right. Absolutely.
1,000% is free. You pick it up. You can watch whatever sermons you want. When you start asking another human to invest their time in you.
Yeah.
It's no longer free at that point. I just want to help you out because your mindset.
Yeah.
So if you want to go get a ball and dribble that joker in your backyard, you good. You don't owe nobody nothing. If you want Isaiah Thomas to come and show you how he won 2 championships by dribbling, now you told Isaiah to come out the house. Now he got to get in the whip. Now he got to come to you. Now he got to spend 2 hours. So I want you to understand something. It's weird to me how somebody would ask, how is this free when nobody ever asked, why does Disney cost this much? Why does a ride that everybody keep getting on? Why do we keep paying it? How do we pay this money? Why is the ride? Why is the admission? Why?
We only question when we invest in ourselves. It's the weirdest thing. No, I'm just saying. I promise you. Ain't nobody thought twice about going to the Super Bowl.
Why does Super Bowl cost $12,000 a ticket? Why? And listen to me. That's for a day. I told you was going to get me for 365.
The wildest.
Every thing. Single day you wake up, you're going to get coached by me. 365. You done went to Disney World for a day and paid thousands for a day. No return on your investment. You done bought a Louis Vuitton purse, $1,000. No return on your investment. That's mindset. That's a mindset. So when people tell me all the time, why church ain't free? Well, because unfortunately, the electricity not. I promise y'all, I would never ask nobody for nothing if the lights didn't cost. If the building, they charge us $5,000, $6,000, $7,000 to rent out House of Hope. And that's on it. And Pastor Dewey looking out love. For me. He's showing love. It's $5,000-$6,000. The parking lot costs. It costs to have security in the park. I'm just saying, to make sure nobody break into your car. It costs. It costs to have security. It costs for the microphone. The band costs. Everything costs. You don't go in the grocery store and ask, why are they charging me for apples when apples is something that God just put on trees? Did you know that God just make apples and oranges grow? But you're not asking, you don't go to the grocery store and go, why is apples free when God created these? You didn't even make these. You didn't make these oranges. You didn't create these watermelons. Why am I paying for watermelons? You know what? You're not paying for God to create. You're paying for somebody to go pick them and take them from wherever they were and put them in the and then bring them to the grocery store and then put them on the aisle for you. You're paying somebody to code them. I'm just trying to get you to understand. So it's a mindset. So I don't ask how much does it cost to be with Rory. I don't ask that. I ask how much does it cost not to be with somebody who helped me to get on the New York Times bestsellers. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And so my time costs, unfortunately, what does it cost? And maybe you can help me out with this, Jose. You got ClickFunnels costs. You got, what's the Stripe cost? You got, say it again. Email, tech, ads, the people who running them. It cost. I'm using Zoom to talk to you. That costs on a phone that costs with the little cheap headphones I got here that came with them. That costs. The lights in here cost. The hotel, everything costs. And the only time we don't want to pay is when we're about to take our mindset to the next level because we don't see the value in mindset. And so More for 24 is about changing your mindset.
Do you ever feel like money is just flying out of your account and you have no idea where it's going? Well, I know. It's all those subscriptions. Think about it. Between streaming services, fitness apps, delivery services, parenting apps, it's endless. So I'm guilty of this, guys. So I used Rocket Money to help me find out what subscriptions I'm actually spending money on, and it was eye-opening. But guess what? I had them cancel the ones that I didn't want anymore. Rocket Money is a personal finance app that finds and cancels your unwanted subscriptions, monitors your spending, and helps you lower your bills. I can see all of my subscriptions in one place, and if I see something I don't want, I can cancel it with a tap. I never have to get on the phone with customer service. They'll even try to get you a refund for the last couple months of wasted money and negotiate to lower your bills by up to 20%. And all you have to do is take a picture of your bill and Rocket Money takes care of the rest. Rocket Money has over 5 million users and has helped save its members an average of $720 a year with over 500 million in canceled subscriptions. Stop wasting money on things you don't use. Cancel your unwanted subscriptions by going to rocketmoney.com/success. Again, that's rocketmoney.com/success. rocketmoney.com/success. This episode of the Secrets to Success podcast is brought to you by BetterHelp. You know, relationships aren't always a walk in the park. There's a common misconception that they have to be easy to be right. But the truth is, the best relationships happen when both people put in the work to make them great. Whether it's with friends, at work, with your significant other, or anyone else, it takes effort. And sometimes that effort involves seeking support. And I'm glad we're finally in a space where we can normalize therapy. Listen, therapy is not just for people with trauma. It's for learning positive coping skills, how to set boundaries. It empowers you to be the best version of yourself. So if you're considering starting therapy, why not give BetterHelp a try? The best part is it's entirely online, designed to be convenient, flexible, and suited to your schedule. Just fill out a brief questionnaire and you'll be matched with a licensed therapist. Plus, you can switch therapists at any time at no additional charge. Become your own soulmate, whether you're actively looking for one or not. Visit betterhelp.com/success today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/success. Take that step towards personal growth and well-being.
I want to ask C this question. C, I need you to go deep on this one for me. Because we're talking about investments.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm not mistaken, your dad worked for GM.
Yes.
Mom, CVS.
Yes.
They had a...
Both of them just regular workers, too. Yeah. We're not talking... Like, some people, your pops worked at GM. He was an electrician or... You know what I'm saying? They had some...
Yeah.
And shout out to my pop. He was on the line.
Yeah.
Assembly line. Went to work, came home.
Yeah.
My mom, CVS, she wasn't
so
no manager.
We would call that a fixed income.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Fixed income.
Yeah, yeah.
And yet they spent, how much money it cost you to go to Michigan State?
Man, I think they spent probably, I mean, my parents did a lot, bro. Like, I really graduated with only like $20,000 worth of debt. It might have been $25,000 to go there a year. So, you know, I was there
from
a minute.
Fixed income.
I was there for a minute. I would say they probably spent close to $100,000.
On a fixed income, they invested in
college.
And I
remember my people would be like, hey, they would get my bill and be like, hey, the bill was, you know, $15,000. We was able to do $9,500, take the others out in loans, and we'll pay that back. Like, bro, my parents weren't taking no vacations. Like, that's real. That's why I say I owe my parents everything. That's why now my mom be like, well, I don't feel right about you taking us to Cancun. I'm like, what? I'm like, y'all did this, but you know, every time they would sacrifice. Like, they didn't buy no new car. They didn't.
And I'm saying,
like, they was making sure they looked out.
Yep. I'm saying, CJ,
mm-hmm.
You have a brother a year younger than you.
Yeah.
Who also went to
college. Yeah.
I just want to keep it real for y'all. CVS, GM,
yep.
Fixed income.
Yeah.
Put these boys through college. They made an investment in their mindset. Can you tell me for the two of y'all how that worked out?
Oh, I mean, I think they got a pretty good ROI. You know what I'm saying? Just based on where we at now.
And it wasn't even for them. They didn't even spend the money for them. They already had their jobs. I'm trying to tell y'all, it's a mindset. When your parents say, we're going to sacrifice our economics and our lifestyle We're going to give y'all this money to go to school because we believe it's going to change our mindset. It's going to change the trajectory. It's going to change who you, the way his father and mother spent money on. He did the same thing about relationships.
And look, too, though, you got to think about this, back to our earlier point. Neither of them ever stepped foot on a college campus, but they understand inflation. And they understood in order for our family to keep up with the Joneses and what's going on out here, y'all can't work. My dad told me, you can't work here. Mm-hmm. Matter of fact, my dad took me one summer and was like, I want you to work here just so you can see how much it suck. He was like, I want you to work on this line. Bro, I'm not playing. Dead middle of summer. This was back when the Green Monster was still there. Dead middle of summer. You get to the plant. I think we had the line started at 6 a.m. So, now mind you, and I'm in college trying to hang out and party. That wasn't smart. You get to the line at 6 a.m., Cleon, I'm not playing. You look at the thermometer, no AC in there. And mind you, somebody, the shift before just got off. You got all these machines working, sparks, like it's hot in there. You get in there at 6 o'clock in the morning, start your job. You look at the thermometer, it'd be 98 degrees, 95 degrees, 94. And you know, Lansing, we don't even live in like Arizona, nothing like that. But it's the plant, and you're in the basement, dog, of a factory.
Yeah, you don't see 94 in Michigan,
ain't no
bro.
Windows.
Nah.
Ain't no air coming through there.
Yeah.
This is not the Delta plant where they at now. This is the old Fisher body. And I remember my dad being like, you need to see that this ain't where you want to be. You know what I'm saying? Like, and again, shout out to my family. I got family, cousins, everybody who still work there and provide a great life. But my parents said, we already did this. So in order for the Quinney family to keep up with inflation, y'all need to go to college. So I'm saying now I got to look at my kids and go, inflation on another level. So that's what we mean by development. You know what I'm saying? And that's what you're talking about by making sure that every generation goes to the next level and you sitting there stuck and you can't go to the next level without taking your mindset to the next level. So for us, being not only fiscally responsible, but it's so funny, man. Let me tell you something. I'm getting old, right? Like, in my 40s. Yeah. Now I'm 41. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm in my 40s. And I called Sean, right? And I was, shout out to Sean Stevenson. I told Sean, you need to start taking Blue Cross Blue Shield. Because I call him more than I call my doctor. You know what I'm saying? Something wrong, my knee, any issue I got. So I had something I was working through with my workouts and stuff. And I called Sean and he was like, oh, you know, this probably, happened because of the thing you had before. And he was like, yeah, that's connected. Then I called him about something else with my shoulder maybe or something. And I was like, oh, and he was like, yeah, that's connected. Actually, that run through here. And I was like, dang, that's connected too. And it was like, the song, the hip bone connected. I think a lot of people don't know that it's connected.
Yeah.
And so your marriage ain't where it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
It's connected.
Yeah.
Your wrist messed up.
Yeah.
It's connected to your family.
Yeah.
So it's funny because, I look at, we talk about growth, right? My wife, it was about probably 2-3 days ago. She was like, yeah, let's have a marital feedback session. I said, oh, okay. Like, I didn't call the meeting, so, what I'm saying? And she was like, shout out to my wife. She was like, you start. I was like, oh, I don't know. Perfection?
Yeah.
You're perfect? Yeah, that's what I said. I said, I don't really had nothing. Like, she was like, no. Like, is there anything, bothering you or anything you wish I would do different or... I was like, I'm good. I said, but please, the floor is yours. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, you called it.
Yeah. And she was like, nah. She was like, look, I feel like we on another level. She was like, love our marriage, everything. I do need more affirmation that I'm doing a good job. And I was like, huh? And she was like, no. She was like, listen, our life is blissful. I'm doing what I want to do. The kids are fantastic. We get along great. Everything is great. But I wish that you would tell me more often. She was like, now you do a good job when you gone. Like when I go on the road, like I'll make sure I got time to reflect. I'm sitting in the hotel by myself. She was like, you'll text me, but like when you here, I don't get that as much. So I need you to work on that. And I'm like, cool, I got it. This is 3 days ago. So what I'm telling you, it's connected.
Yeah.
So bro, I'm about to go to a whole nother level with my wife because of communication, which is going to allow me, her to be on another level, which is going to allow me to be on another level, which is going to allow us to be on another level, which is going to allow me and E relationship to stay going strong and me up, get on the road or do what I need to do. Like, she ain't tripping if I say now, because I fix, because I'm fixing it. If I say, E say, oh, we need to go here and do this, she not looking at me crazy. Some of y'all, your marriage, your relationships are the reason you're not on the next level financially. And that's what E talking about, getting to that next level. Or it's connected.
Yeah.
The hip bone connected to the backbone.
And let me tell
backbone
you.
Connected to the neck bone. And it's like, yo, you and your wife ain't getting along. And you like, oh, I ain't, or you ain't doing well financially. Yeah. And now your marriage messed up. Somebody told me the other day, it was a good friend of ours. And me and Mar was talking. And they was like, yeah. His wife tripping. And I was like, careful. And he was like, nah, what you mean? Like, and I was like, we get one side of the story. I'm saying, I don't know what my man doing to make his wife act like that. We getting his story, but his wife wilding or whatever she, I'm saying, why she feel the need to wild out? Why she having a midlife crisis?
Yeah.
I'm not trying to be funny. Didi ain't having one. Yeah. Camille ain't having one. Candace ain't having one. They seem to have a midlife boost.
Yeah.
And I'm not, and maybe she just is, but I'm saying it's connected.
Absolutely.
It, and if you see it as connected, I see, bro, I'm talking about, bro, it's so connected. E, we were joking earlier about chunky and whatever. I noticed that when I'm not in, like, feeling my best physically, things affect me differently.
Absolutely.
Like if I feel like I'm not, like, and you know what I mean, like, at our age, in shape and out of shape is like a week apart.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just saying, if I'm eating right, I'm in the gym, I'm working out, I can take on challenges better.
Yeah.
When you know you've been on vacation, sloppy eating, and you just kind of like, you know, your clothes ain't fitting quite as, and then you get a call that, I noticed that it's connected.
Yeah.
I'm like, all of a sudden, this stressing me out when I'm feeling in shape and I'm feeling good about myself, I'm like, oh, okay, let's fix it.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yo, so much is connected. And that's why you always talked about living that 360 life and that well-balanced life. And I promise y'all, I tell E all the time, I thank him all the time. I'm like, bro, I see cats in our industry, cats in other industries blowing up and getting divorced and getting caught up in affairs and all of this stupid stuff. And I text E all the time. I just say, thank you, bro. Thank you for starting with my character, bro. Like, thank you for starting with that, because E understood it's connected.
Yeah.
We not going to be able to make the kind of money we want to make if you still doing stupid stuff, see? We not going to be able to get to the next level in our relationship if you don't value these relationships. I love it, bro. Cats ain't got a relationship with their kids and want to hang out with me.
Right.
Like, I go back to the crib and I'm like, you don't see your own son.
Right. How you want to talk to
him? You got time to talk. Like, you like, what? You see what I'm saying? Like, I don't even trust that.
Yeah.
I'm saying, you did your own kid dirty.
Yeah.
What you'll do to me?
Yeah.
But it's connected. And that's why, again, I want you to look at your life, and we all got the five pillars. The More in 24 is not just about financial.
No.
It's not just about spiritual.
Oh.
Some of y'all super spiritual and broke.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, I was talking to my, I don't want to get the names out, but I was talking to my mother-in-law, and she was telling me that there was a kid in the church who just recently started coming to APOC who was like, yeah, I don't understand why God's so deep, because my auntie and my mama love God and talk about God all the time, and they broke. Mm-hmm. He was just like, I don't get it. They always talking about God, and we've been broke since my whole life.
My whole life.
And I'm like,
nah, money.
But I'm saying, my man, like, it's supposed to be connected.
Yeah.
I'm listening to all this elevation talk. I'm listening to all of it. It's supposed to be, it's not. So we're not just talking about spiritual. We're not just talking about finance. It's like, it's everything.
It's the
More in 24 is
it's
more.
It's the mindset.
It's inflation everywhere.
It's the mindset. Everything is connected to the mindset. That's why he said, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
Because for a lot of us, his mind is not in us.
Yep.
Culture is in you. You still, listen to me. You still getting programmed by your culture. It's the funniest thing. You still getting programmed by, you know, like, you might be African-American, or you might be from the South, or you might be at a particular denomination. I'm done with all of that. Why? Because that's not the mind of Christ.
Mm.
So that's why you have a church that might be booming in one area, but they're not booming another area because they only focusing on one thing. God don't focus on one thing. You know what I'm saying? That's why he God. And he said, let this mind. So to your point, how you in church and you the deacon, but you ain't talking to your kids. That ain't the mind of Christ. That's something different. God would never tell you, I want to read this to y'all. I thought this was deep. Hold on. Let me see if I can. I don't know what's going on with my phone. Y'all gotta see this. This is deep. This is mindset. Watch this. She said, this is right today, this morning, right after the Morning 24.
Yep.
She said, good morning, E.T. I just wanted to reach out and thank you for today's Morning 24 call. Your message really hit me in my gut. I realize I've been focusing on gaining, but not maintaining. This is why I say you got to have a mind in Christ. Because you think rich, listen to me, you think wealth is more. Wealth is actually taking care of the little you have. That's what more is. You ain't taking care of your wife, and you think God about to give you more? You're not taking care of your personal, like your hygiene. You think God about to, you think, listen to me, it's a mindset. You think more money means more. It doesn't. More means you have, he said, be faithful over your bedroom. Yeah. Clean your bedroom. Do your homework. Be faithful in little, and I'll give you more. Watch what she said. This was going to blow your mind. She said, but not maintaining. And it's put me in debt. She in debt. We're about to get to this. This is crazy.
Come on.
She says, I'm struggling to pay off my debt, even though I make six figures. So you didn't think this part was coming. You didn't think the six. Yeah, it is. And why? Because I heard somebody say the other day, if you making $1 million and you spending $1 million, you ain't got no more money than the dude that's making $100 and he didn't spend $100. You and him got the same amount of money.
Yep.
So it's a mindset. But watch what she says. She says, anyway, I'm focusing on becoming a better steward and letting God take control. I appreciate your willingness to show me where I need to shift my mindset. Have a happy Sabbath and continue to let God to use you. I'm just trying to show you. You so busy on your marriage is terrible. Because you're so busy, like, not growing. So you got your wife as a hunter, but the reason why you're going to get other women is because you still have that primal thing in you that wants to hunt, but you've not learned how to hunt inside the hunt. You haven't learned that you can hunt in the hunt. You ain't got to go outside the hunt. You can hunt in the hunt. Somebody called me the other day, man, I'm ready to get a divorce. I said, what's up? Bro, my girl tripping. I said, what is she doing? He named all the challenges. I said, I thought you played college football. What that got to do with my marriage? I said, bro, you weren't running from the defense when you was playing football. You was excited about the defense. You saw it as a challenge. Yeah. You watching the film and figuring out next time we play them, because we play them twice. Next time we play them, I'm about to hit them with the, and I'm about to, now you in practice lifting weights, you squatting, you getting your legs stronger.
Yeah.
Cause you want to make sure that the next time you see my man, but then in a marriage, all of a sudden now you don't like challenges. You running from challenges. If you had the same mindset you had when you played football, who wants to watch sports and there's no defense? Who wants to watch sports and they just all offense? Catch it, go. Ain't nobody. Who want to watch with no fouls? Don't nobody want to watch that? But in your marriage, you just want all offense. You got the wrong mindset. And so what I want to teach you is, I want to teach you, oh, yeah, when Didi was young, I could get her with the purse. I can't get her with the purse in the car no more. She got those. But I'm not going, oh, no, I'm not going to woo her no more. I'm not going to lure her no more. I'm not going, you know what I'm saying, explore and innovate no more. I quit. No, now I'm about to go, okay, we did the money thing. Okay, we did the school thing. Okay, we did the career thing. Okay, what can I get her on now? How can I? Oh, okay, I got it. Jada is, okay, yep, we're going to help Jada get go to school. We're going to help Jada get her master's. Oh, we're going to help Jada get a, okay, got it. Okay, bro, Jada came home. I brought Jada two books that she needed to become a dope counselor and then gave her the money she needs to start working on her assessment tool. So, I mean, the test she got to take to graduate and get her. Her mom passed her NCLEX on the first one. So I'm like, okay, Didi, okay, got it. I'm about to take care of the kids in a way that go make my wife go, okay, I see what he all right now. Yep. I'm just saying, I'm not sitting here going, a regular season, we ran through them. Now we in the playoffs. We ran through them. Now we in the Super Bowl. We getting our butt kicked. No, I'm about to go, we in the Super Bowl in my marriage. We ain't playing scrubs no more. Yeah. This ain't regular season where you could check the Pistons off four times.
Y'all been together how long?
34. It's a different mentality. You see the Pistons, check, check, check. Oh. You see the Lakers, like, it might be a dog fight. You see the work, the Denver Nugget, you got to play different to beat the Clippers right now. This team they got, you got to play different. You can't just walk in there with your normal mood. And I'm saying your mindset, you giving up on your marriage because you was dope for regular season. You whack for the NBA finals. Mm. That game you got right, it's a whack game for the finals. But you pissed because you was running through them in the regular season. This ain't regular season now. This ain't regular season. And you don't and you don't get rewards for I think they do got an end season term, so forgive me. Right, but I'm just saying, my era, it wasn't no end season championship. Yep. So the person I have to be to win an NBA final and bring home the hardwood is different than it was when I was playing regular season. I'm in the finals now. I ain't quitting and giving up. I ain't running. We about to perfect our game and take it to the next level. Actually, I'm not even trying to beat you in the finals. I'm trying to sweep you in the finals. I'm trying to sweep you in my marriage. Yeah. I'm trying to sweep you in business. I'm trying to sweep. Listen to me very close. I'm doing more than 24. Let me tell you something. I want to see the other cats out there who are willing to do 30 days for free.
Yeah.
Who are willing to get up at 7:00 in the morning and not give garbage. Who are willing to be live. Bro, I ain't tripping. I'm not saying other people not, but I guarantee you when you're doing 30 straight days, you're not going to have problems with that regular season cats. The regular season cats ain't doing 30-day challenge. They doing 3-day challenge, 7-day challenge, and they trying to hurry up and get it done. We going 30. The next one, I might end up doing 40, 45. You feel me? Why? Because I got 45 days in me. I got it in me. I got that kind of content. And it's going to get better every day. So I'm just saying, you got to change your mindset if you want to change your money. You got to change your mindset if you want to change your marriage. You got to change your mindset if you want to change your movement, your momentum. You got to change your mindset. And for a lot of you, it's not your fault, but you came into the world in an inferior mindset and you still in one. So we are inviting you to get around like-minded people and get into a different category in your mind for $1,000 a year. More in 24. Somebody give them a link or something. I don't particularly know it, but put the link up here. Let them get the link. Look forward to seeing y'all the rest of the year.
That's it. We got to get to church. We love you. We out of here.
We'll see you next week.
I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You make this, you concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your soul.
Thank you so much for rocking with us as always, right? We don't take it lightly, guys. And we hope that we've provided transformation and not just information. We want you to become the best version of yourself, right? Make sure you check out the show notes to access all the important links and get your product discounts. Now, one favor we're asking of you, do us this favor. Make sure you subscribe and leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. We want to know your feedback and how we can serve you better. And if there's anyone that you think could benefit from listening to this show, please, I'm begging you, please share it with them. And remember, as E always says, if you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.